Have you ever wondered what it takes to build your own off-grid dream house in a remote woodland setting?
It is really deep into the forest. It's surrounded with trees.
With the generator, it wasn't ideal. We had to go and connect the generator.
But every installation is an experience. Each installation is a new adventure.
In this video, we follow one family's journey to a life deep in the forests of France and learn how they've achieved it with the help of Victron Energy. And later in the video, we'll be showing how off-grid electricity can help water extraction via a borehole. Pierre and Anais moved to this remote woodland north of Dijon 3 years ago. As daunting as the project seemed, a number of kilometres from the nearest town and with no on-site electricity, they had very clear reasons for taking on this new off-grid way of life.
To me, it was really important to not pollute the environment and to be very eco-friendly. Because I just had 3 children, I had to ensure that I showing them the proper ways in order to have comfort without damaging the environment.
Making the move even more daunting was the fact that Anais was heavily pregnant when they moved onto the property, which was far from ready for a modern, energy-hungry family of four.
It is true that when Piero had seen this house, he wanted to move in there. He fell in love at first sight. I was thinking about family, children, being a mother. I have another vision. I think, why not? But autonomy. It's not necessarily going to be ideal with 3 children and another to come. We had to adapt a bit. We had a little fear, but in the end, we made it. With the generator, it wasn't ideal. We had to go and connect the generator when we needed it. Then at night, in winter, it happened regularly that the generator would cut off and we would have no electricity. We would find ourselves completely in the dark, and if we were in the middle of something without a lamp close by. Initially, the children were afraid, and then, at the end, it had become almost a habit. It was, we were laughing. But it's true that it took an adaptation time.
The generator they were relying on so much was getting through 5,500 litres of fuel per year. They needed a greener, more reliable and cost-effective alternative. So Pierre approached a local Victron Energy installer for help with the project.
Pierre came to see us for this, and we've been thinking a lot. It was a beautiful project in the middle of the forest, and that's what we were also interested in. To make people completely off-grid at the forest level.
The wooded location, shaded heavily by trees, proved challenging for optimum use of solar, and the roof was too old to take the extra weight of the panels. But included in the property was a bit of land on the other side of a small road, and luckily was clear of trees, a perfect position for solar panels.
The previous owner of this house had already put tubes for me to pull the cables. It's about 150 meters away from the house.
Before the full install, Pierre carefully took readings from all of the appliances in use to determine what exactly was required. He now has 24 400 watt panels, which generate around 10 kilowatts of energy. And with Emmanuel's help, he installed a 48 volt 8 kVA quattro, along with 2 RS450 MPPTs. All are monitored by the VOM system. The new setup is robust, and it needs to be, not only for household appliance usage, but also for the water extraction and purification system that Pierre has had to implement.
We have a borehole that goes 100 meters deep. We have the pump down that needs to pull up the water for 100 meters. So this consumes electricity almost a third of everything we need in electricity in here. And then the water goes up and with pressure, and that pressure comes into the house, and then it's filtered with pressure, and then we can have it on the tap right here.
With so much at stake in this project, the choice of the system was key to its long-term success and stability. Something not lost on the family, nor installer Emmanuel.
Victron was the only brand for me who met expectations in the sense that already we had a very good quality product. We had an after-sales service which was very interesting, and above all, a technical intelligence service that was also really very, very successful. That's why I became an installer about 10 years ago now, to go even further in evolution with Victron and really be sure that the Victron product lasts as long as possible.
After a rather fraught and expensive first year off-grid, the family can now reflect on how much easier life is with the Victron Energy system they've installed.
It was really hard for me. I had all this stress. Then, when the solar system was built, at first I was looking at the GX Touch screen all day long, you know, wondering how much energy is coming, and I was kind of still worrying because that's the way I used to live. All the stress goes away. Suddenly there was no pressure, and I could be just be myself.
Now we have solar power. We also use nature, the sun, to have electricity to be able to heat up. I find that suddenly we're much more in harmony with our environment. We reduce our impact as living beings on the planet. We appreciate it. It's very pleasant on a daily basis. It feels like we do things right. We're moving in the right direction. Yes, we're really happy to live like this.
Yes, of course. Anyone can become autonomous today. It's really a matter of adapting the behavior to nature. We've always wanted to live outside of nature. Today, with this way of life, we realize that we have to live with nature. It's not very complicated. It's just that instead of having, for example, hours of the day and hours of nights with the EDF network, we can very well simply have hours with sunshine and hours without sunshine. If we understood that, anyone is capable to become self-sufficient.
With a growing family, Pierre and Anais now have the space, know-how and support to scale a Victron Energy setup. They also hope to turn one section of the house into an Airbnb property, opening another much-needed income stream, whilst at the same time offering visitors a chance to sample the simple delights of an off-grid life in a French forest. We have a YouTube playlist dedicated to off-grid properties, so why not check it out?